Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the next edition of the Classic Plastic Mega Man X Marathon. And as you can undoubtedly tell, the next title we are loading it straight from the 2005 Mega Man X Collection on the PS2. And if you're wondering why we're going to do that route, well, believe it or not, because that's the only way you could actually play a console version of the 32-bit release of Mega Man X3, believe it or not. And yes, I've already unlocked Battle and Chase a long time ago. Anyways, let's go ahead and get started. And as many of you may know, this was actually a very late release on the Super Nintendo back in the day. I believe it was like December 95, January of 96. And this was after the PS1 was already making rounds. Although 96 was when the PS1 and Saturn version was released. And damn it, come on. So, let's go ahead and get started. And by the way, none of the cutscenes are voiced, I just figured I'd stay quiet on that one. Anyways. Integrated in the gameplay. That's interesting. Now then. This was also the second game that used the CX4 chip. So, and it was also the first one where you got to play as Zero, but not as a completely separate campaign. But that was just a sign of what was to come, though. There we go. So other than music and sound effects and FMVs, the only other difference is load times, especially if you're playing the original PS1 or Saturn version. Or if you were extremely lucky and had a decent PC at the time, the PC version, which sadly never got re-released at all. Never in the X Legacy Collections, let alone not even as a standalone release on Good Old Games. I mean, Capcom and Good Old Games did it with the 97 or 98 late 90s PC release of Street Fighter Alpha 2, so why not this one? But, and here's our new edition. No different than X in this game. Charge up to two shots with an extremely powerful Z Saber. And his own life, too. But the thing about Zero is you do not want to lose him or get him killed. Because when he gets killed off in any stage that you decide to swap out to, that's it. You lose him forever. There's a particular time you do want that to happen for your benefit. And I'll point that out once, as soon as we get there. Come on. Well, that takes care of him. Interesting enough, the intro from the Super Nintendo version of this game was never utilized at all. Ah, Dr. Doppler's Mechanoloid. That is our main enemy in this game. And a long time ago, one of my buddies said this makes him look kinda like Dr. Robotnik. It's the mustache! Interesting enough, I should point out Europe was the only English-speaking area region that got the PS1 and Saturn version. We got stuck with the PC version. And, yes, there's a save file. Hey, why not? I got no problems doing that. Now then. I'm gonna tell you right now, it doesn't matter which of these you choose, they are all going to kick your ass. But if I had to recommend one, it's this one. And also, interesting enough, for every Maverick that you choose that you haven't beaten, they have their own intro FMV, which I thought was pretty cool. Anyways. And yes, this does sound like my Melissa from Guns N' Roses. Hey. Tank. Damn it. No!
All right. I'm going to write on you. Thank you. How? Get as much health as you can. This is the other reason why I recommend you go after Neon Tiger first. Ooh, can't get that. And yeah, the tracks loop very much like Red Book audio. Got him. All right, since I don't have any of the ride mech units. And yes, there are X-Hunters in this game, and there's only three of them again. One of them is going to be a very familiar face. Spike makers, don't step on them. Instant death. There's our heart tank. Alright, we should still be good. No, no. He will always block your shots, so... Thankfully, he does have a fairly readable pattern. Oh, damn it. Get off of me. Oh! Okay. No! Ah! I was trying to hit the start button. You know what? Actually, a fairly decent chance. Let's try this again. Ow! Fucker! God damn, he is not playing fair. There we go, stay directly underneath him. That's what should have happened. Whoa. It's like that. Almost done. Got him. Now, the rest of this game's challenge will start falling like a stack of dominoes. Other than one or two enemies, now this is what they use the C4 chip for, showing off with the weapons. Alright. Let's go. Almost got everything. You're next. Love this one. And those are black hole generators, or is the this game calls them gravity wells. Definitely a military air base. Extra man, thank you. And I do have the SATA version, only it's the Japanese version, and there's one difference I have noticed between that and the PS1 version, and that is because of the Saturn's resolution display, I forget what the measure is. I wouldn't be surprised if that's what's causing Symphony of the Night on that system to just lag. Well, Capcom decided to make some nifty frames around on it for each stage. They're actually pretty neat. And they're only exclusive to that version. kind of like how a certain couple of bosses were exclusive to the Saturn version of Mega Man 8. All right. Here we go. Like I said, all like a stack of dominoes. And that's it. And I actually do like that rendition of this artwork. Dr. Doppler. Saw that coming. Really, dude? Now come the new X Hunters. We got Bit and Bite here. Who's that handsome looking dude? Believe it. Now then. Let's go. And they don't show up on the map like the last game, so it's all pretty much luck-based. Now then. Hang on. Now that I've defeated two of them, some areas should start opening up now. More specifically... Nope! Not yet. Oh, aim to summon Zero? Go to your menu, shoulder button. Please show this bit off real quick. All right. And then, of course, you can switch back to X. Alright. Figured I'd show that off. Now then. Back to business. Still no armor parts yet. And there was actually going to be 4 32-bit versions of this game. I should have said that earlier. The Panasonic 3DO, but that version got canceled. And it would have been just like the PS1 Saturn version. If I had a certain weapon, I'd be able to get the main right armor module, but I unfortunately don't have it. Alright. Possibility of an X-Hunter? Yep, and it's Bite. Or Bit. It's actually easier than he looks, because he does have a pattern he can follow. Not yet. Now. That's because I don't have the one weapon that'll kill him. Because if you were to kill both him and Bite, you would not face a different boss later when you go to Doppler stage. All right. There we go. Just the weapon I need. Perfect for flying enemies. Ow. Fucker. You're done. And in life, I am terrified of bees, wasps, any flying insect that has a weapon on its ass because they're absolute assholes. Anyways. Parasitic Bomb. A very appropriate name. Now then. Back here. Blizzard Buffalo. Your obligatory ice enemy. With very slippery terrain. Can't go down there yet. Ow. That would have nearly killed me. Be facing bite. Nope. But we are gonna face a X Hunter. And I'll show you what I mean in a bit. Go down here. And there's our portal. Elevator, huh? Fallen debris. E-tank's full. Go. Well, looky here. It's Vile. If you don't beat him in this with the weapon that kills him, you do face him again with a much bigger mech riding mech called the Goliath. Thankfully, he's easy. Just like in Maverick Hunter X. That's it. Don't count on it, buddy. Time to get the hell out of here, because this will be a first of the X series. A self-destruct sequence. Oh, extra life. Oh, I'm gonna skip it. Hey. Jump into hell with the debris. Made it. Now, let's continue on. Alright. Who's ready for an armor upgrade? I sure as hell am. Alright. It's here! That's where I need to go. Oh, close. This is always the tricky one to get. There we go. Oh yeah. That's how I'm going to get that E-Tank you saw earlier. I need help. Alright, let's go. Very easy. Booyah! Who wants barbecue? On ice. And what do we get? The one weapon that would have helped me kill Bit. But, oh well. Now then. Find out. It depends what enemy I see. Now we should be able to get it. That way I can get both things that I miss instead of just the one. Heart tank, check. How? Yeah, now the rockets don't home. There we go. We got the frog right armor. We'll need that. For now. Well, hold on. Yeah. Taking a page from Terminator, I see. Well, Terminator 2 to be exact. On. All right, go up real quick. I'll take that. All right, are we fighting him or not? Nope. Yeah, that's right. I still need the main unit. Come on. Come on. Not bite. I know this for a fact. You gotta deal with that thing. There we go. All right. Water drains. Come on. And that's a sign that the tank is full. Alright, let's go. This way. Damn it, there we go. Yeah, that easy. Worse than Toad Man from Mega Man 4. acid burst, more like splash. Alright, take you out, and I'll start doing some backtracking. Put Gutsman to shame. Oh, come on. There yet. All right. I think this is where I fight Bite. Yep. Oh yeah. A magnet. Gotta admit, that's a pretty clever trap. And you're done. Just like that. Well, at least we don't have to put up a file, but if you didn't destroy Bitten Bite or just destroy one of them, but not the other, you do fight their combined form later in the final stages. Anyways, just thought I'd point that out.
Damn it!
Ah! Damn controls. Hang on. Eek. I know where I could get some more lives at least.
I was not holding up.
Damn. there. Alright, we're here. There. Excuse me. Dealt with. Now then. Tornado thing, huh? Alright, time to do some backtracking. We'll come back to you again later, but right now... time for an armor upgrade. Which is helpful sometimes. Now, how's this overlap work? Well, go ahead and show it off, X. Nothing to write home about. Ooh. Now we're fully done with Neon Tiger stage. Fully done. Not yet. Fully done. Not yet. So let's go here first. Now, there is... You can get a secondary armor upgrades, but there's a problem with them, and I'll get to one of the capsules and show you. Alright, can't activate it yet, but we will get the main body. No! Wait. Where am I at? Where am I at? All lives. Oh, yikes. There. The one time it is actually helpful. We gotta deal with this thing again. There we go. Time to get that right armor. Also, we can get a heart container too. Or heart tank, I mean. There we go. Oh yeah. And there's our health tank. Now, let's see if I think it was close by that I could get another life. No, it wasn't here. Alright, let's get out of here. Fully done. You. Thank you. There we go. It's one interesting way to go through a door. I need you. No. That's how you get your right arbors. And they have their own health meter too. Jump. There we go. Moving on. Now we need to head to Blizzard Buffalo's stage. And I believe I actually get a heart tank. From X2. Yeah. We're done here. Next up, Vault Catfish. Pay close attention. Look familiar? It's a neat little detail seeing Otto from classic Mega Man in this. Where you get a heart tank. There. Just play it safe. Should be an area this way. It's here. Now, how do you get up there? This is where the gravity well comes in handy. More specifically, a charge shot. Body armor. And there's our demonstration. Now we do need to take a slight detailer. Here we go. Right here. Super easy. One more. And there you have it. Beaten. One of the more neat weapons, really. And when we need to finish up a tiny bit of backtracking, which is here. right here for one of them. Okay. Not here, but further down the road. It's here. Here we go. Fully upgraded. Now, how's that about that radar? Kinda neat when you think about it. Does not work on the final stages though. To the final Maverick. And, yep. Tells you what I'm. The question marks, those are enhancement chips, which are the secondary armor upgrades. The downside with those is they can only upgrade one of the four vital parts of your armor, and you can only have one installed. But, if you're like me, there's a neat little trick which we'll do real soon. Crush Crawfish. And since we have not visited this level at all, show off that radar. That's where our three items are. And one of those right close by. There's that. That's where one of those chips is. Again, we're not going to go there. So, plus this is where I should be able to get a couple of lives. Down here. Oh, come on. Come on. Right here. There we go. That'll help. No! And I lost them that quickly. Well, one of them. Ah, oh, damn it. It's almost charged. Or maybe they can respawn. Hey, that helps. Takes care of this sub. There we go. Just the weapon. Dealt with. Hmm. The one weapon effective against Neon Tiger. Now then. Believe it. Now, we got everything. Time for the two special items. Yeah, did I say we were going after one? We're going after two. So, here we go. Special item number one. Keep your health fully charged and your tanks full. There we go. Move fast. Like so. Not charged yet. All right. I know where we can get a right armor. Oh shit, but first... There. Alright, that takes care of health. All right. 10 to charge up my health and fill my tanks. All right. All right, come on. There it is. There it is. The gold chip, and aptly named. And if you're staying still, when you have damage, you can regenerate. Pretty helpful if I do say so myself. Now to deal with one loose end. It's that thing. Ow. You're dealt with. At long last. Now then. I got one shot at getting this right. For item number two. Come on. Where is it? All Not here.
Oh, it was! Damn it, I fucked up! Oh!
Yeah, take me out. Oh, damn. Us again. All right. Come on, let me change over. Thank you. There. Now we get Zero's Beam Saber, but here's, so we get, and, oh yeah, Nundaki. Here's what I mean by regenerative. Like so. It takes for effing ever, but it's there if you want it. Ooh. Now for our boss. Since we defeated Vile, we don't have to worry about him. This thing we gotta worry about. That's how effective that saber is. Perfect for much later down the road. Beaten. Now then, the gauntlet. Yes, that gauntlet. Ooh. That's how you regain energy. And it is finicky as to what you get out of that. Yes, you did see me do dash twice. An ice beam. That takes care of him. Let's regenerate a little bit. Next up, now let's really bring him down. Bam! Oh yeah. What else is being charged? No way. Oh, this is sweet. I forgot all about that. All right. Yep. All right, that takes care of that rhino. There. There. Takes care of him. Okay.
Now, deal with you. That's for earlier, asshole. Final one. You're dealt with. I'll need this. Fat chance. Do not attack him. Now. Because if you attack him when he's standing like that, he will put up a field and regenerate his health. Needless to say, you don't want that. Thankfully, he's got a readable pattern. You know what? Hang on. End this quickly.
come up. There we go. Beaten. Yep, the Sigma virus. Now then. Final stage of the game. No, that's not it. Now then. There. Damn. There we go. That's half of the entire fight. But Kaiser Sigma. Damn. You got to hit the back of his head. There we go. Damn it. Got him. Phew. Thank you. So if you threw your controller down at this point, you better pick it up. Because now you got an escape sequence. Now we're done. It's dead end. The only proofreading that this game ever needs. Which is why I really don't jump back into this collection a whole lot compared to the newer one. Just for this game and Battle and Chase. Just like Gundam Wing, X has yet to learn that there is such thing as peace through strength. Yeah, I think Capcom jumped the gun on this little tidbit right here. And that right there was Mega Man X3 on the PS1 / Sega Saturn / X Collection on the PS2 / GameCube. Ugh, that was a mouthful. Nice little flashback of the capsule that X was discovered in, as well as his early days as a Maverick Hunter. That's the name of the machine Bit and Byte combined to make. Not a bad image. Not a bad image. All right, so when we meet up again, folks, we will be tackling, believe it or not, not X4, but Extreme 2 on the Game Boy Color. So, with all that said, guys, thank you so much for watching. Have a fantastic night, and take care.